Hello, hi, I'm Laura, I'm still French. I'm gonna watch Riverdale season 3 episode 19. I'm not gonna do it with my hands, with my fingers. I'm sick, like you can hear. I have a deepest voice than usually. Sorry for that, but that's it. I'm sick. It's a little bit windy today, so maybe you're gonna hear it also. Like I said so many times before, I want to see more about the farm. You know my obsession with the farm. I want to see how Edgar is acting with everyone. I want to see how this thing about the dead people is working. Of course, they are hallucinating, but how can they believe in that? I don't understand that. I want to see it, I want to understand how it's working. I'm sorry, but because I'm sick, I'm gonna talk a lot, even if it's not good for my voice. But when I'm sick or when I'm tired, I speak too much. I'm gonna have so much work with this video, with editing this video. I can feel it already. Okay, that's enough. Let's go. Oh yes, the Gargoyle King kidnapped Jelly Bean.
Hey, why is the door locked?
You, I don't like you.
What's wrong?
His blood is on your hands. No, but his blood is all over Archie's hands, literally.
Both of you.
You killed me, that ring.
I think, in my opinion.
First, your avatar.
Now, I'm really gonna play this game. I can't. Every time that Luc Perry is on the screen,
he would like to be transferred to one. And I thought, since you own the place.
Are you really asking that, Betty?
The king already knows your darkest truths.
Yes, tell the truth, just to change.
Please!
Please.
Wife is on the line. If you don't say something, I will.
Yes, me too.
What's he talking about? I'm the new Fizzle Rock dealer in Riverdale, and Kurt ceased to work for me before he lost the damn night because I wanted to keep you out of it. I did to protect you, to protect the family.
No, protect yourself.
Huh?
Only.
You're the reason that this psycho kidnapped our daughter. You brought this into our lives. I've heard enough.
Me too.
We'll finish this damn game. There will be a reckoning.
Get out, please. We don't like you.
After the big wedding, Edgar's planning to adopt Juniper and Egwene.
What? First, they're really gonna marry each other?
I posted your barely
and he's gonna adopt our daughter's kid? What?
The results of the drug tests taken by Archie Andrews and Mad Dog Moore have both come back. Negative.
He
murdered our brother!
This wants to believe me if I could take back.
What can she find in our file? In Evelyn's file?
A junior? Yes, that's what I thought. Thank you so much. She's been repeating her junior year, enrolling in different high schools, pretending to be 17 for over a decade.
A decade?
I think from what I found, Edgar works on the parents while Evelyn is sent to high school to recruit teens into the farm.
I like the music. It's a music like in Tarantino movies.
Now do you see why I need to get the hell out of this town?
Juniper and Dagwood must be protected.
I agree. That's my
point. Yes, from him and from you.
Someone else might help. Someone uniquely motivated to help you.
Auntie, you know what it's like to be adopted into a family that only wants to control you. Where's you? She's staying. We get them away, but Edgar keeps the girls.
What?
The only terms that they would accept is
you don't separate twins.
They're twins. You can't separate them.
Yes, please.
Isn't even their father, but Polly is their mother.
You're not sacrificing one child for another? No, this isn't. How can you accept that? I'm gonna be mad. I'm gonna be really angry. I don't know. Please. Oh, shut up. Nobody knows you and nobody wants to know you.
Riverdale's our home. Dad and I live here.
It's your home.
We're happy here.
Yes.
It's you. You destroyed that.
Get out.
Problem with the Cyclops. Cyclops.
What?
It's not a character class that I've ever read about. So give me that check. And I'll let you leave here in one piece. Yeah, I'm not gonna do that.
That's it?
Is the one who called me the Reaper? You should be being around since 10 times this.
Who are you?
Petty Peabody.
But...
You were the Cyclops? I thought you were
dead.
Yes?
Is that what Mommy told you?
No. It was an eye for an eye.
How much?
6 to be exact.
Whoa!
I also found this. Evelyn is Edgar Avenir's wife. Nah, daughter.
That's funny.
Tony, are you in a place where you can talk?
It's we're gonna you see them kissing now? Ew.
I'll drive.
That's it. That's our goodbye.
The prize money from Gilda Gloves and some donations Rana can pull together.
I don't like that. On compense pas la mort de quelqu'un avec de l'argent? Ou? Yes, please. Save her too.
Preordained. No.
What?
No, not you too. Why? My whole life I've been searching for a family. The serpents. The great poisons.
Tell me you're lying, you're bluffing.
Mom.
Tony, please.
You can't marry Edgar. He's already married to Evelyn.
Yes. She knows.
I don't know that. There are no secrets here at the front.
Birk.
Why are you all smiling? What is this about? You, Betty,
join us.
No.
Everyone you know. Everyone in your life is here in this room.
No. Jughead is not. Archie is not. Veronica is not. Shut up.
Join us.
No. You're creepy. You're so creepy, all of you. Don't. Betty?
Yes.
No! Yes, please, thank you.
Please.
No? What is that? In what world? This is not creepy. No! Again! You're not frightening anyone.
Ricky.
Oh, this is a goodbye
something
moment.
I need to tell you.
Yes.
Ricky, I've loved our time together.
Oof.
And that's okay.
Stop with that, with this expression endgame.
Somewhere
it's a word for fans, not for characters.
First thing tomorrow, me and Jake, you're hitting the road.
No.
You're not taking Jake
with you.
Yes, please. Yes, please.
She should stay with Anna. And so should you.
No. Please. No. I'm sorry for you, Jelly Bean, really. But it's really better for all of you.
You take good care of my babies, alright? And yourself?
You too, Klaus.
For once, you seemed honest. I'm not feeling sorry or sad for her. I'm like, okay, maybe another time when you came back, you will come back. It will be better, but now I don't want to see you.
Your dad and a few other inmates were being transported to my father's prison and...
They escaped?
There was some kind of accident.
Did he escape?
No.
Is that?
There were no survivors.
Oh, I'm not sure of that. I want to see the body. If I don't see the body, he's not dead. No. I don't buy that. I'm sorry, but I don't buy that. If I don't see the body, he's not dead. He's crazy enough to do it himself, this accident thing. I think he did it himself just to be free without anyone searching for him. No, I don't buy that. Sorry, but I don't buy that. You're not gonna have me with that. If I don't see the body, he's not dead. That's the rule. The rule. This episode, it's really like the last one. I'm not sure I can say it was a good episode, but I don't see anything bad that I can dislike also. They are really rushing every scene, every actions, everything. It's just scenes after scenes, and we don't have any big moments. We only have the goodbye of Josie. Josie is now out of the show. I really liked this character, but I didn't love her. I was like, oh, she's sweet, she's nice. She was the sweet and the nice girl of this show. Betty was this girl during season 1. After that, she was a crazy one. So Josie took that role, that place, by being the sweet one. Now she's out, now she left. I don't see anyone being the sweet one. Jelly Bean can be the sweet one of the show now. So yes, Josie left. I think I read that she's gonna have her own spin-off now, so she left for something good. So goodbye for now, Josie, and I see you on another show. About this episode, about what happened during this episode, like I said, the writers are really rushing everything, so I just remember one other big thing about this episode. It's the wedding between Edgar and Alice, and the fact that Alice knows that Edgar is already married to Evelyn. That's really a sect. If we needed another proof to call the farm a sect, that's it. A man who wants all the women to be married with only him and who wants to adopt all of the child, that's a sect. When Betty was running away from the farm with everyone, running after her. It was really weird and really scary. I find it scarier than the Gargoyle King. Now, just to see the face of the Gargoyle King, just to see this mask, I'm like, no, again? Really? I had enough of this Gargoyle King thing. That's enough. Too much, too much. It's too much history about that. It's too much noise about that. Now, that's it. We have to know who is he. We have to move on from that. The farm, it's even scarier than him now. I don't buy this thing about Betty's dad. I said it at the beginning of this review. I don't buy it once. If I don't see the body, I don't buy it. Maybe on the next episode, it's gonna be his funeral and we're gonna see the body and I'm gonna be like, really? Or something like that. But for now, I don't believe it. I want to see the body. I don't know why I took an Italian accent to say that. Like, my French accent is not enough. Okay, that's all. I have to finish it. I'm really sick and I speak too much. I'm gonna be really mad at me, at myself, when I'm gonna edit this video. So, stop. It's all for me and it's all for now, so bye for now. Bye.